Jom kampung ni kena keluar.
Finally reached Johor. Yeah, we're here. Selamat datang Johor. Okay, so apparently there's some sort of welcoming that's gonna happen real soon. Like, I don't know, maybe some music and fireworks. I'm not sure what's gonna happen. All I know is, according to our itineraries, that we will be riding a boat, and that's where we're going to eat our lunch. I fell asleep. I don't even know what time it is. But yeah, look at that. There's a city view over there. Okay, you won't see it, but right. So there's a lake at the back. So we are going to. Oh, okay. We need to wear this. We need to wear a vest because we will be riding a boat. What are we gonna do in the boat?
I have no idea. My first time here.
It's our first time here.
Salah tangan tu.
Ah.
Okay, salah.
Okay, oh my god.
Okay, duduk. Duduk.
Okay,
slowly.
Okay. Wah. Okay, for now, this is us in a boat. Gonna catch a crab. I'm with Alisa. Yeah, because there can only be two people in a boat, so yeah, we're partnering. We're partnering,
yeah,
all the way.
Romantic.
What? Oh wait. Oh, let me see. What's that? So this is the trap. Okay, so this trap we will use to catch crabs. So as you can see, there's like fishes inside the trap, and Aliza's gonna let it go. Let it go. Hopefully it's a big crab or Sebastian. Seaweed is always green. La 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 la. Apparently, apart from catching crabs for lunch, we are to check out the mangroves. So relaxing, really. And we're riding with our guy Hashim.
Hamdan.
Hamdan, yeah, we're riding with our guy Hamdan right over here. Hello.
Hello.
Oh! I so love the air. If only you guys were here. I'm gonna stop taking a video because I just want to relax and enjoy the experience right now. So, see you later. It's nice to see natural beauty being preserved here in Malaysia, since Alisa was just telling me that there was a similar mangrove in Melaka, another place here in Malaysia that was changed into a river bank or something, so that they can build buildings in there and proper streets. But you know, I still think that we need to preserve our natural resources and natural attractions that we have.
You can see the difference from this part of the area
crab, yay!
Wah, banyaknya.
Biru dah api.
Muscles, you mean like this?
You have a really nice boat, man. He like, he really shows us around it and tells us stories and details about the places here.
Well, oh,
what?
But no, thanks to Aziza, that is. Nah. Both of them are Indian. I don't think they're together. I don't know what they're talking about, to be honest. So this is the fish farm, apparently. Yeah, we're here at the fish farm, and I don't know what we're gonna do here. Probably catch some fishes or crabs. I don't know. I'm just going along, but look at this. Yeah. Whoa, 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 whoa! Help me, help me. Help the fine lady. Okay, check this out. Okay, we're now approaching the fishing area.
If you're tired when you're fishing at night, you can just like
look at them.
Well,
that's what he says.
That's what he
says. That's what he says.
Ini dipanggil racket stick. Maknanya awak semua boleh minyak di sini. Boleh memancing. Boleh buat barbecue.
So our tourist guide was telling us a story of why they came up with this idea of setting this up. Basically, this is to, since I was not able to understand what he's saying because he was talking in Bahasa, my personal translator, Aliza, told me that the purpose of this is that they wanted to give the fishermen here additional income. This area is being run over by buildings and such, so this is to give them an opportunity to earn more, and this is also an opportunity for us, for the tourists, to learn more, to educate them. And actually each of the paintings in here has a story to tell. They're actually there for a reason.